This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina, and our podcast today is on Ida B. Wells' Undaunted and the Press. By the time Ida B. Wells bought one-third interest in the newspaper Free Speech and Headlight in 1889, she had already established herself as an educator and one of the most important women journalists in the United States. She described her work as editor, part of her profession, as her real vocation. Being African and female made this career even more challenging for Wells. She was personally and professionally confronted with racism and sexism. Blackness was more easily and frequently assaulted, and her activism put her at risk for racial retaliation. Her role as a woman was always in question, and on more than one occasion, she had to challenge personal attacks that she was not a wholesome, virtuous, or even Christian woman. But one of her most admired traits was that she was not easily daunted. Wells understood the power of the media, which at that time was the power of the press. A legacy from Europe, print media was the oldest and most popular form of mass public communication. With the introduction of stereotyping newspapers, it was also very inexpensive. Press stereotyping used fixed type to make a primary mold that allowed for metal plates to be produced, whereby newspapers and books could be reprinted cheaply. Wells used this media to mount one of the most important challenges to the lynching of black men in America. In doing so, her research revealed the nature of black male-female liaisons that led to the murder of black men. She also condemned the rape of black females during the period of slavery up to her present time. She was direct and adamant in her assertions. Quote, "The more I studied the situation, the more I was convinced that the Southerner had never gotten over his resentment, that the Negro was no longer his plaything, his servant, and his source of income." Unquote. Wells was exiled in London after the 1892 murders of three Memphis, Tennessee businessmen. Her life was threatened because she held the white newspaper, the Memphis Daily Commercial, and local authorities responsible for inciting the mob that carried out the lynchings. Southern papers defended their position on the lynching of blacks to the London press and continued their assault on Wells' character, well aware that she was actively soliciting anti-lynching support abroad. The English newspapers, in alignment with Wells, denounced the Memphis Daily Commercial and questioned the idea of American civilization and the need for lynching. For Wells, the press was always more than a collection of papers which chronicled the events of communities. Wells advanced that print media should be held accountable for what was distributed, and it must be used to educate and correct information for people. The mass media that Wells faced was lodged in two separate and distinct spheres. There was one area that aggressively challenged the black existence, or as Wells's contemporary T. Thomas Fortune wrote about the Southern press, quote, "There is always some circumstance that justifies the murder and exculpates the murderer. The black always deserves his fate," unquote. The other area upheld the civil and human rights of African Americans. It was a difficult interracial dialogue rooted in the history of American slavery. Ida B. Wells represented the interest of justice for blacks in her effort to provide the accurate facts of lynching and the Southern white newspapers attempting to repudiate those facts. They also were at the same time just as vigorous in their attempts to discredit the journalistic ability of Wells, but both sides knew that it was a classic battle for the hearts and minds of newspaper readers, both black and white. More importantly, it was about the extra-legal extermination of black men as the ultimate expression of racial supremacy. The American news media of the 19th and early 20th century spoke to these desperate people, helping to organize their political, economic, religious, and social thoughts in one direction or another. But through it all, Ida B. Wells remained fearless.